Welcome back. Joining us now to answer your pet questions is Dr. Emily Reger from Falls Road Animal Hospital. Good morning.
Good morning.
And you brought us Cruz.
Yes, this is Cruz. He is a 10-month-old standard poodle.
Come here, Cruz.
And as you can see, he has a very fancy haircut.
He's actually
a show dog. And this is his puppy cut for his competition.
He's very soft and he's very lovable.
He is. He's wonderful.
He's amazing to look at. And the owner has a 10-month-old, or a 4-month-old, right? A little puppy.
Correct, yes, so, a black standard.
So that would be so much fun to see what a little one looks like, too. He is a really great dog, and
yes.
He's a show dog, too. And he sits like a person, we were noticing. He's great.
He is.
Well, it's weird. All our questions this morning are about exotic animals, so we're going to start with a gecko.
Okay.
So this person has a question. My gecko has a swollen eye and has stopped eating. What should I do about this problem?
Well, I'm guessing that you have a leopard gecko, which is the most common type of gecko, although there are several others. But in any situation with a swollen eye, there's always a risk of a bacterial infection. And what can happen is that bacteria can be sort of under the skin, under the eyelid, or even associated with their dental, you know, with the dentition there. And they can get a swelling that's basically bacteria and inflammatory cells. Very often what we have to do is open it up and drain it. And the discomfort from all of that will sort of steal their appetite away.
So make sure you see
your vet. Definitely. Yep. Go see your exotic vet and let them know about, you know, the appetite and everything. Sometimes they need a little supplementation to make sure that they're getting enough protein in.
Well, someone also has a bird that needs some help. My 10-year-old Conyer began laying eggs every November about 5 years ago. I've tried decreasing her daylight hours. She eats less, and I give her calcium, protein, extra vitamins, but I still worry about her. What else can I do?
Well, that is a tricky question. Birds that are laying eggs inappropriately can be very scary because they will steal the calcium from their bones, they'll steal the protein from their bodies, and they can become very weak if they are not well controlled. So there are a few other behavioral modifications that you can make. If you think about a bird, a bird's life in the wild, a bird that is in migration, a bird that is traveling and in flight, is not going to be nesting. They're not thinking about reproduction. And so sometimes it helps to change their cage around a little bit.
So they're not so bored.
Move the perches. Exactly. So basically make them feel like they are moving, like they are in flight, okay?
And They'll actually believe that?
Well, it sort of tricks their hormones. You can even move the cage around the room a little bit, shift it so that the light comes in from a different angle. You know, these don't always work, and sometimes in really severe situations, you have to go to the vet and start hormone injections.
Oh, boy. Okay.
And every bird's a little bit different. Some birds will need this injection once a month. Some birds only need it once a year. You sort of have to work it out with your doctor and with your bird.
Change of scenery could help.
Sure.
That's good to know. Okay, the next person. I recently had to put down an 18-year-old dove. Oh. She was mating with my other dove, and I understand they mate for life. They were together for 10 years. Will the surviving dove be okay? That's a really sad one.
That is a hard question. And sometimes when they are very strongly bonded, it can be very difficult. Sometimes if you get your other dove, basically a sort of replacement, not necessarily another dove, but you could even use a toy, or if there's a perch that they spent a lot of time on together.
It might help out.
Also, you know, birds are flock species, and so they can sort of bond with other members of the flock, meaning you, your family members. You
know. So there's hope. They don't have to worry that necessarily their dove
will
die.
Absolutely. There is absolutely hope.
That's good. No, Cruz, you are such a good
Very
puppy
good
today.
Boy.
Thank you so much for helping. He deserves lots of treats.
Yes,
thanks, Emily. We have much more.